says about arches, right?
Yes.
We are directly going to solve one example. And one another thing. After this one, we are left with one topic only. And this is the remaining topic. It is also deflection. Right? So after this one, we are left with one more topic, and that is deflection.
Deflection?
Deflection. So the remaining time after this class, it is towards deflection, deflection. Okay? Okay, so. Our discussion is about arches, and more specifically, we limitize our discussion about 3-inch parabolic arches, right?
Yes.
So 3-inch. We discussed its the element theory, right? And I should told you that if you have a 3-inch parabolic arch, so we place our origin at the highest point, and the equation of the center line of parabolic arch, it will be y is equal to
minus
rise over
half square,
right?
Into x square.
Square into
x square.
And we can find the direction of the axial and shear force at any point, right? Okay. So now I am going to explain all these things by using a simple example.
FH, same as the cable, right?
Sorry?
FH.
There will be no FH. Okay. So in this case, we will not consider for FH, right? Our discussion will be only from this equation. Okay, so the problem is show that the 3-inch parabolic arch is subjected to axial compressive force only. This is the statement, right? You need to show that the 3-inch parabolic arch, it is subjected to axial compressive force only. This is your arch. Okay. So what we will do, we will consider one point over here, and we will find the forces. Okay? And we will see that shear force will be zero, bending moment will be zero, there will be only axial compressive force. So that's why I can see it's, but the other way to write this problem is, find the internal forces at point D for given arc. So basically what is happening, we have a 3-inch parabolic arch, and this arch, right, its both ends, they are at same level, right? And this is the point at which we have the third hinge, exactly in the middle. And we, it is subjected to a UDL, right? It is subjected to a UDL. It is 10 kilonewton per meter. Let me increase it a little bit. 12 kilonewton per meter, right? So now what we have to do, we need to find, we need to show that in this parabolic arch, right, there will be only axial compressive forces, right? And these distances are 20 meter and 20 meter, right? So what we are going to do, this is 20, this is also 20, right? and the height of this parabolic arc, this is 10 meters. So from here to here, this height is 10 meters. Now to show that in this arch, there are only axial compressive forces, what we can do? Let's say this is point A, this is point B, this is point C. We can consider a point D over here. We can consider a point D at any distance, at any point, right? And let's find the forces. Okay? Are you following me in this?
Yes.
So basically we need to answer this problem, right? That the three in parabolic are subjected to only axial compressive forces. There is only one way that I consider an arc. At this point I find the force and show it only axial forces here, right? Okay. The same thing, it can be written as find the internal forces at point D of the given arc. You understand?
Yes.
Okay, so this is point D. Let's specify its this
location.
Right. This is also 10 meters. This is 10 meters. Easy, right? Okay, now for this in parabolic arc in the solution, what will be equation of center line of an arc?
Y squared.
So equation of
center.
Center line of an arc, right? So you will have y, it is equal to
minus
rise over
half span squared.
Half span x squared. Mind, I am not writing is at h by 2, right?
Yes.
Or l by 2. I am saying it the half span, right? Square into
x squared.
Yo, in this case, what is value of rise? In our this case, rise is how much it is?
10 meter.
10 meter, right? Half span, right?
20.
Yes, it is given, it is 20 meter. Therefore, our y value, right? It will be equal to minus. Rise
10.
Is 10 divided by half span will be
20
meters square into x square. So y will be equal to minus 1 over 20 x square, is it?
Yes.
Oh, sorry, minus 1 over 40 x squared. So what is this equation? This equation shows us this shape of the parabolic arc, is it?
Yes.
Okay, let's check it. If you put x is equal to 0, what will be y value?
0.
Mm-hmm. Means this point, is it?
Mm-hmm.
Because this is our x axis, this is our y axis, is it? So x is 0, y will be 0, right? Now, for this point, what is value of x? It is
10.
20. What is value of x for this point?
20.
So it is 20, right? So let's put 20 over there, right? So what will be your answer? So y is equal to minus
1.
1 over 40 into
10.
20 square, right? So it will be equal to minus 1 over 40 into
minus
400.
10.
So it is minus 10. Is it correct?
Yes.
So this distance is minus 10. Is it?
Yes.
Okay, what about this point?
The same.
Again.
Same.
So what will be value of x for this point? It is
minus
20.
Yes.
Is it?
Mm-hmm.
Minus 20. Let's put minus 20 over there. So minus 1 over 40 into minus 20 square. Again it is minus 10. So this equation, it is clearly giving us the shape of this, the center line, this is the equation of the center line of this arc. Okay, so it's easy to understand, right?
Yeah.
Next. Now let's find the spore reaction first. Okay. Now for the spore reaction, this is the equation, right? Now next is for
support.
And I told you last time how to find the spore reactions.
Separate.
So just divide it into two parts from here, is it?
Yes.
Okay. And this reaction over here, we will have it vertical at A, here we will have horizontal at A. So this will be vertical at B,
horizontal.
And here we will have horizontal at
B.
You can consider any direction, right?
Mm-hmm.
At the end, if it is negative, change it. Okay. So now let's separate it from point C into two parts. Okay. The left part of this arc will be like this one, right part is like this. Okay. And both of these parts, they are subjected to
UDL.
This UDL. This is also subjected to this Mind it, this is gravity UDL. This type of UDL we call it as
gravity.
The other one is, this is not gravity, right? It is acting along this one, but for arches it is always gravity UDL, okay? And this UDL is 12 kilonewton per meter. This is 12 kilonewton per meter. Okay, what about distance? This reaction is vertical at A. Here we will have horizontal at A. So here we will have vertical at B and we will have horizontal at B. Now, the distance, right, from here to here, right?
10.
So this is 20, right?
Yes.
20.
And this distance, right, this is also 20 meters. And this height up to this point,
10.
Yes. This one is 10 meters. And same over here, this height is also 10 meters. Okay, now at this point, right, we will have the shear. This is vertical at C, and same will be over here, is it?
Yes.
And we will have horizontal over here, horizontal at C, or axial at C, and this will also be
same.
Horizontal at C. Now, in this figure, this point is A, and this is B, or sorry, this is C, right? So this is AC segment, and this is your C,
B,
B segment. So let's solve these two ones side by side. Now for this part, for segment BC, here I am making the calculation for segment C. Summation fx will be 0, summation fy will be 0, is it?
Yes.
Okay. And
moment.
Summation of moment will be 0.
Yes.
Okay, so now the easiest way, right? Okay, I can tell you a easy way. You take the moment at point A, right?
Mm-hmm.
What you will get? You will get an equation in which there will be this unknown, VC and IC will be unknown, is it?
Yes.
Okay. And this is. So this UDL, it will produce a movement in this direction.
Yes.
Okay, now what about this part? Now again,
sir,
take movement at point B. You will get an equation in terms of BC and SC.
Yes,
yes.
Two equations.
So you will have two equations, two unknowns. Solve them, you will find XC and BC.
Yes.
So when XC and BC is known, on this part apply summation FX FY 0.
Find reaction A.
Find these two
reactions.
Then over here, find apply summation FX FY 0, you will find these two.
Yes.
Easy?
Easy.
Okay, so let's apply summation of
x
moment.
Moment at point
A
equals
zero.
So at a point A it will be equal. So
clockwise.
You can consider the clockwise is equal to counterclockwise. Okay?
Yes.
So the clockwise moment, it is equal to
counterclockwise.
So now at point A, how many forces are producing clockwise movement?
12 kilo.
There is only 12 kilonewton which will produce clockwise movement.
Yes.
This BC counterclockwise, XC also counterclockwise. Okay.
Yeah.
So what will be movement from this one?
12 into 20.
It will be 12
into 20.
Into this length, it is 20, right?
Yes.
Into 20.
Into 10.
20 over 2, right?
Yes.
So this is movement in clockwise direction. In counterclockwise, it will be equal to BC into 20 plus
HC
into
10.
Okay, so
simplify.
I can simplify it and I can write it as
VC and HC.
So from here,
2 VC plus.
Just a minute. So this will be 10. So this will be 240 is equal to 2 VC. Plus HC.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
right.
Because I divided this equation by 10 and simplified it. Okay. So what will be this one? 20 over 2, 10, right? So 10, 10, it will be finished, right? So only this will be left, 240. everything is correct.
Yes.
Okay. Then for this part, for segment BC, let's apply summation of moment at point
B.
B.
Equals to zero. Then again we can consider the clockwise movement is equal to
counter.
Okay, now at point B, how many forces are producing
HC.
Clockwise movement at point B, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
So the clockwise it is
HC.
So BC is counterclockwise, HC is clockwise,
yeah.
12 is
counterclockwise.
So only HC it is producing the
clockwise
movement. So and that movement will be equal to HC multiplied with
10
equals to counterclockwise from 12 into
20.
20 into
20 over 2.
20 over 2
plus
VC. Due to VC, right? VC into
20.
Okay, again, let's simplify it. You will get HC is equal to 240
plus 2VC.
2VC, right? So you will get HC
minus.
So 2VC minus
HC.
Minus HC, it is equal to what?
Minus 20.
Minus 240.
Yes.
Is it correct?
Yes.
So 2VC minus HC is equal to minus 240. Now let's solve these two equations. Equation 1 and 2. So what you can do, just simply add these two equations, right?
Mm-hmm.
So what will happen?
Cancel HC.
HC
will delete.
So
delta C will be finished, is
yeah.
it?
Yes.
And 4VC is equal to 0, is it?
Yes.
Yeah.
So this gives you 1 and 2, right? Solving 1 and 2, what you will get?
VC is equal.
So just add these two 1.
Yeah.
Okay. So it will be 0 or 4VC. Plus 0 is equal to 0. Is it correct?
Yes.
So your VC value is equal to
0.
Okay. Then, now put this value of VC over here or over here and find HC, okay?
240.
Therefore, okay, which one you want to use?
Any
one. It's
240.
Okay, let's put it over here, right?
So
VC is put over here.
0.
So HC will be equals to what?
240.
Therefore, from 1, right? Your HC, it will be equals to 240 kilonewton. Okay, from this one.
Minus HC will be equal to minus 240.
So, minus HC will be equal to minus 240. Minus and minus finish, again HC will be equals to 240. So, positive, right? So, both are positive. So HC is positive, VC is positive. It means direction of HC and VC is correct. In this one and in this one, everywhere it is correct, okay?
Yes.
Agreed?
Yes.
Okay, next.
Victor.
Yes.
We know that shear force is zero. Why
That's
I'm
why we are getting the same answer, right?
Why I'm finding it?
In some cases, it may not be zero, right? If it is not parabolic, right? So that's why we have to follow a general procedure. In this case, it is zero, right? And we are getting it. Anyway, we will discuss it later.
Because you said that show that. So, like a proof.
Yes, it is. But that proof, we will made it for point D, right?
Yes.
So, for to find the reactions.
So, this is not... not
this, in one way, it is proof, right? But it is only for the shear. What about bending? It is a hinge, right?
Mm-hmm.
Bending is already zero. Okay, so now... after finding HC, what's the, HC and VC, what next? We can apply summation FX FI 0 on this part and FX FI 0 on this part, right?
Yes.
And find the sport reaction, okay? And now, for again, for segment AC, and this is for segment BC, okay? Summation of FY equal to 0 on this part. This will give you VA.
VA will equal to 12.
Plus
zero.
BC equals to
12 into 20.
12 into 20. So VA, right? We don't know the value of, what is the value of VC? It is zero. So therefore VA it is equal to 240 kilometer. Then, now apply summation of F, X equal to zero on this one. So HA will be equal to
HC.
HC. So therefore, HA is equal to 240 kilometer. So we have found the vertical and horizontal reaction at point A.
Okay.
Now let's repeat the same thing for segment B, right? So now let's write summation of FY0 for this segment. So you will get VB. Okay. So what will be that? It is VB upward, right? Minus VC and minus 120 into 20, right? Sorry, 12 into 20, is it?
Yes.
So it is equal to 0. So your VB, again you will get plus 240 kilonewton. Exactly on the same basis, summation of Fx equal to 0, you will get Hc, sorry, Hb is equal to Hc. This is in this direction, this is in opposite direction. So you will get horizontal at B, it is also equal to. For this case, we found all the reactions and we got an answer that vertical at A, it is equal to how much? 240. So this is how much? It is also 240. This horizontal at C is 240. Vertical at C is 0. This horizontal at C, right? It is also 240. This vertical at C is 0. Horizontal at B, 240 kilonewton. This is also, so by chance we got the same answer for all the spot reactions. Okay, so now we find the spot reaction. What is next step?
To find the.
Now we are interested to find the forces at point
D.
D. Okay. So now let's find the forces at point
D. Find the theta first.
Find
theta.
Theta, yes.
Okay.
Okay, so considering point D, right? Considering. So reaction is over, right? For spot reaction, we completed this part. This was for the equation of the center line of force, right? Now, next one is for calculation of internal forces, right? At point D. Okay, now for point D, first let's find its basic geometry. Let's solve its basic geometry, right?
We have to find the angle.
Yes. But before angle, we need to find its x and y coordinate, okay? So here is our x axis, this is our y axis, okay? Now, equation of this line, y is equal to minus 1 over 20 into minus 1 over 40,
yes,
into x square, right? Now we know the distances, right? What is this distance from here to here? This is 20 and up to point D, right?
Yes.
So this distance is how much?
10.
So this distance is 10. This is also, okay, what will be this distance from here to here?
With the
okay.
We'll get the
so for point D, right? Yes. For point D, what I can do in this equation, I can put x is equal to
10,
right? So y at x is equal to 10, you will get minus 1 over 40 into 10 square. So it is 100 over 40. You will get minus 2.5. Minus 2.5 meters. So y and x is equal to 10 meters.
Yes.
So what it means, what is this distance?
Minus 2.5.
Minus 2.5. Minus means it is
down
below the horizontal axis. Therefore, it is negative. But
yes,
in actual, we will write only this height is 2.5 meters. Okay, what will be this height from here to here? Total is 10, right?
Yes. 7.5.
You know, the total height from here to here, this is
10
meters. So 10 minus 2.5, we will get 7.5. Okay. So now I am going to draw a section through point A, because I know for point D, I know everything, right? I know what is the this distance from the spot, what is this distance, vertical distance from the spot, from point C, all the distances are known, okay? Now passing a section through point D and considering right side, okay? Next is passing a section through point D. Considering which side? Right side, okay? Considering right side. Now let's cut it over here. And consider this right side, okay? So now, for this one, this is the situation, is it correct?
Yes.
Yes.
So now over here, at this point, we have one spore, and we know the spore reaction, right?
Yes.
So we know this reaction is how much it is?
240.
240 kilonewton. This horizontal reaction, it is also 240 kilonewton, right? And the distance up to point D, right?
7.5. 10.
So this is 10 meter, and this is?
7.5.
This 7.5 is large, 10 is small, but anyways, let's go with it, right? Okay, so this is 10, and this one is 7.5. Point D, right? So this is our point D. When you will cut it, so how many forces are exposed?
Two.
Okay, which one?
Horizontal and vertical.
So there will be one force which is shear, and shear is always perpendicular to its center line. Shear is always perpendicular to the center line, okay? And the axial is always along the center line. Okay? So we will have now two forces. One will be exactly along the center line. Is it? And the other one will be perpendicular to it, right?
Yes.
So this will be, let's say, this is our...
It's downward.
It's okay. Let's consider upward, downward, there is no difference.
Same, same, downward.
Okay, we will get the negative sign. Okay. So over here, this is vertical force at point
D.
This is axial force at point
D.
And also there will be a movement at point. So there will be a movement at this point. What else? There is UDL also, right?
Yes.
This external load, right? Do not forget this load, right?
Yes.
This load is there, means on this part. Okay. And this is 12 kilonewton per meter. So over here, there is a
UDL.
There is a UDL. And that one is 12 kilonewton. Now the first thing which is required, it is the angle of the tangent.
Yes.
Okay. You see, this is basically this line, right? It is like a tangent, is it?
Yes.
So we need this angle, right? Either this one or this one. One and the same thing. So how to find this angle now? Can you understand?
Differential.
To find this angle, right? So let's find the derivative and put y equals to the distance up to point D, right?
Yes.
And take equals to 10 theta, okay? As I explained you last time. Can you recall?
Yes.
Okay, therefore, for angle theta, right? For sigma theta D, this is theta D, is it?
Yes.
Now for this one, theta d, either this one or this one, both are the same, right? So we have the basic equation, y is equal to minus 1 over 4t into x square. Let's find its derivative, dy over dx. It will be equal to minus 1 over 4t into
2x.
Correct?
Yes.
Okay. So this will becomes dy over d equals to minus 1 over 20x. Is it correct?
Yes.
Now let's find dy over dx.
At x
equal to? X is equal to?
10.
10 meter, right? Which is D point, okay? And this will be equal to minus 1 over 20 into x value is 10, right? So it is equal to minus 1 over 2. And it is equal to what? 10 of theta D. Is it correct?
Yes.
So because these two things are equal, right? Therefore, its value will be equal to this one. So from here, you will get theta D. It is equal to minus something. Can you check? Just put
26.5.
Minus 26.5.
Tan inverse.
Yes, tan inverse of minus 0.5, right? Mm-hmm. So you will get 26.5. Okay. What is the meaning of minus?
Clockwise.
Clockwise
from the horizontal.
Yeah, it's from the horizontal. It's
clockwise.
You know, usually you measure the angle. This is your x-axis. This I repeated it previously, right? So for this line, this is the angle in which you measure, right, is it?
Yeah.
So 0, 90, 180, 270, and so on, right? But if, now in our case, this line is here, right? So obviously you are getting measuring in negative direction, okay? So our answer is correct, clear?
Yes.
So what is our theta value? Basically it is
26.5.
Okay, 26.565. Okay, now we know this angle, right? So if this angle is theta d, what will be this angle?
90.
90 minus.
This one. This and this are same.
Yes.
It?
Yes.
Okay. So if this is theta d, now what will be this angle?
Which angle?
From the first line.
90. 90 minus theta d.
Which
one?
90
minus.
90
minus.
Angle
over here.
90
minus.
Shear
force. 90
minus.
Theta
b. Yes. Almost correct. But let's draw it in a in separate figure and find the value. Do I use this space? Okay. So over here, one is here, right? And the other one is
90 degree over there.
It is at 90 degree, right? So this angle is 90, right? Okay. So what is this angle from the horizontal?
That's theta d.
This one is theta d, right?
Yes.
And it is 26.565. What will be this angle?
90 minus.
Because the angle between these two.
90.
So this angle from here to here, it is 90, right? So what, this is 26.56, what will be this angle? 90 minus 26.56, okay? 63.435. 63.435. So we got an idea that this angle, right, it is 63.435. Okay, so now, on this whole system, in this whole system, how many unknowns?
Just two. One, two, three.
We have three unknowns, right?
Yes.
So it is
moment
V, D, A, D, and M, D. All other things, distances, angles, everything you know, right?
Yes.
Okay. So now let's find these three unknowns by applying summation Fx0, Fy0, and moment 0. Okay. Now let's apply summation of this space is limited. I use this one. Do we have 5 more minutes?
Yes.
How much time?
11 minutes.
Why it's noisy outside? So these forces, let's apply summation fx0, fy0, and movement 0, okay? So now, summation of fx equal to 0. So what you will get from fx equal to 0? So 240, right?
Yes.
Minus 240, is that correct?
Yes. Mm. 240.
This is at the right?
Yes. We are applying summation fx0, not at point D, for the whole system.
Yes.
For whole system, right? We are applying, right?
To,
yes.
to find the unknowns. Okay. So it is minus 240.
Plus.
And then.
Plus AD cosine.
And mind it, this angle is theta D.
Yes.
This is also theta D, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So it is.
Plus.
BD. Plus.
Plus AD.
Sine.
Cosine.
Okay. For AD, right?
Cosine of
AD into
cosine
of
theta D.
Minus 27.
What is the angle?
26.565.
Okay.
Yes.
VD. Then plus
yes.
VD into
VD into cosine
63.435. Why both are positive? Can you see it's 240 is along the negative direction. VD, its x component will be this one. It is towards the positive direction. This AD, its component is also in the positive direction. Okay? So it's finite, right? So summation fx equal to 0, this gives us this equation. Now, summation of fy equal to 0, right? Now, summation of fy equal to 0. First, the vertical reaction upward it is 240 minus downward UDL is 12 into
10.
Again, 240.
12 into 10
minus
AD. UDL, right?
Yes.
Now, from the
minus
VD,
AD.
Also. VD is positive, right?
Yes.
So, plus VD
sine of
63.435. Plus VD. It is equal to 0. Sine of 63.435. And cosine is minus. Is it? Sorry, AD is minus, right?
Sine.
AD sine of
26.565.
All is 0. Is that correct?
Yes.
Because this VD, this 240 is upward, positive. UDL is downward, it is negative. This VD, its component is positive. This AD, its component will be
negative.
Okay.
We
so
can
now
find
in these two equations, we can find
AD
two
and
two
AD
unknown, right?
Yes.
Okay, so what will be solution of this one? Can you
so
add
them together, sir?
No.
AD equal VD, doctor.
Okay, check now come here. This one is finished, is it?
Yes.
No. 120. Remain 120.
Okay, thank you. So this is 120, right? So 240, this is 120, so it is plus 120, right? So 120 is equal minus AD. What is sine of 56.56? Okay, plus
0.447.
VD, tell me this factor. Sine of 53.
Not cosine.
Sine of 26.
AD is how much? Sine of 26.56?
0.447.
0.447, right?
Yes.
Plus
VD into 0.567.
Okay. So can you modify this equation is equal to 0, right? So this will be equal to minus 240 plus, take this one, cosine of 26.565. Yes.
0.56.
This is not correct?
No.
Yeah.
It's
0.894.
0.894. Yes. Okay. Then cosine of 26.565 is?
Sine of 63.
Yeah, this cosine and this one, this will be equal, right?
Yes.
0.8944. And plus VD, and this cosine will be equal to this sign, 0.447. Please check.
Yes, sir,
right. Is equal to 0. Now solve these two equations.
Yes.
Can you solve from
yes.
calculator?
Yes.
You know how to solve it on calculator,
yes,
right?
Yes.
Okay. And this will be equal to 240, 120, so easy, right? So from here, can you tell me what is the value of AD and BD? We have some answer of AD. In the calculator you can solve it, right?
One equation.
Two equations.
You have two equations, right?
Yes.
So just change the mode, both equations and
mode 5-3.
Select the equation.
Mode
5-3? Yes. Okay, shortcut.
What is
telephone?
Manual
is easy?
Tell him the
number.
Only
two
number.
Okay,
good.
Then tell me the answer.
كده انت حاسب يوم واحد
طيب
268.34 and this is you find it you got the answer 0.04 okay no problem 0.04 and this is 268 right if this value is 0.04 and this value is 0.23, is there is comparison, right?
Mm.
Right?
Mm.
But if this is 0.04, this is 268, almost this is 0.
Yes.
You understand? Okay, any other answer? Did you get the same answer? Nothing?
The AD is minus 268. Right?
Why minus? Positive.
Minus.
So AD is, it must be positive. So maybe you put something negative or something different over here, right? Check it again. If it is negative, it's not correct. So it means your audience is in tension, right? Okay, so easy way is, okay now, easy way is just put this value over here. Okay, so mean this will be finished. Now this 268 over here. Can you check? 268.34 multiplied by 0.447.
Yeah,
119 or something. 119? 0.052. Okay. So you will check it. It is also 120. So this answer is correct, and it is positive. Okay. If you need, I can solve it, right? Like a plus b equals to 2 and so on, right?
No need to.
I think you can easily solve it. Okay. Okay, so now you find VD is equal to 268.34. Okay, next is
moment.
Moment.
Yeah.
Now let's take summation of moment
at point D.
At point D equals to 0. Okay, so what will be moment at point D? Now at point D, MD is there. In which direction you are considering?
Clockwise, counterclockwise.
Okay, so now let me close the discussion. This answer is correct, and you will solve it, you will get the same answer, okay? Okay, now next thing is, try to understand the next point, it is more important, okay? Usually the students are confused in this part, when you are taking moment. I can tell you a very simple idea, that when you are finding the moment at some point, okay, do not leave any force, any moment. For example, over here, now you are finding moment at this point, right? So what will be moment due to VD?
Zero.
That it should be ignored. AD?
Zero.
It should be ignored. What about MD?
Yes.
You should add it.
It should be considered in the equation,
yes.
Right? This UDF, it should be considered.
Yes.
This vertical horizontal should be considered. Consider everything over there, okay? So now, at this point, and again, consider clockwise equal to counterclockwise. Now, what will be the clockwise movement at point which at point D, right? Is MD is clockwise, no, counterclockwise, right? Clockwise is from this UDL
and
from this 240, horizontal 240, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so it will be equal to
12 into 10.
120 into
ten over two
from UDN
plus
240 into
7.5
into 7.5
is equal to
now counterclockwise.
The moment
first is MD itself.
Yeah.
Then
240
plus 240
into 10.
Into 10, right?
Yeah.
So when you will solve, what will be this answer? Can you tell me?
Zero.
Yeah, it should be zero, right?
Yeah.
But what is value of MD? Can you find the same answer? Because this is 2400. Just find these two, one if it's 2400.
Yeah.
Finished? Did you anyone who can tell me the zero, right?
Zero.
Okay. So now what is our result? Now what is value of VD?
Zero.
We found it. VD is equal to what? It is equal to
zero.
Zero, right? What is AD? Sorry, MD it is equal to. So AD is equal to plus 268.34. So this shows you what is clear from this values.
There is
the shear is zero, moment is zero,
compression.
There is only axial compressive force, is it?
Mm.
And that one was our main objective, right? That for a 3-inch parabolic arc, there is only axial compressive force.
Yes.
So and our results are showing the same thing, is it? And at the same time, we are. If the question is find the forces at point D, we are also finding the forces. Okay. So based on this one, we can write our final result.
Of D itself, D.
Yeah.
So
D.
So
at
point D.
For a 3-inch parabolic arc.
Only the axial compressive force is
present.
Our result is. So, what are our results? The axial force at point D, it is equal to 268.34 kilonewton. The shear force, right? V at point D, it is equal to 0. The moment at point D is equal to 0. Therefore, so this result, this shows that. For a 3-inch parabolic arch subjected to
UDL,
only gravity UDL, right? Okay. Will have no shear force,
no
bending moment. Only axial compressive force will be there. Compressive force will be
present.
Now, the practice problem, this question is over. Now, the practice problems are in your book. And these are from 525 to 532. Problem number 525 to 532. So these are the practice problem in your book, right? Then next one is for the same question, right? Okay. If I add two point loads, one exactly in the middle over here, one exactly in the middle over here. What will happen?
What?
For this same problem, right? If I add one point load over here, one point load over here, what will happen?
Shear force.
They will listen.
So it means at point D, shear force will not be zero, bending moment will also not be zero, right?
Yes.
Okay. Or the UDL is not there, there is only one point load. What will happen?
It's also not zero.
Also, the shear force and bending moment will not be zero, right?
Yes.
So such type of change is possible in the question, right? I can give you a question that the earth is parabolic, but it is no more subjective to UDL, right? UDL on some, on left side it is different, right side it is different, right? So accordingly, your values will change. But the procedure is? So alhamdulillah, we finish our this topic also, and we are left with only one last topic, okay? And that is the deflections, okay? Deflections further by using energy methods, okay? Right? Okay, thank you very much.
So this minus I'm getting, it's because the VD, it's opposite direction, right?
So you, VD is zero. VD is zero, there will be nothing, right?
So why I'm getting minus?
Okay, I will tell you. Because if you put negative over here, you are using the same equation, right?
Yes.
If you put negative over here, right? So this is not getting zero answer, right? If you put minus and zero over here, will you, these equations will not be satisfied.
Yes.
Right? It means there is something wrong with your solution. Agreed?